Hello and welcome. Complex query management, distribution, and updates often create issues with downstream consumers or enable consumers to access information they shouldn't. The use of SQL views for data management can mitigate these risks. Views are indeed a well-established best practice that provides a number of advantages, and we're happy to announce that you can now leverage them within Infor Data Fabric. Some of the key benefits of using views include limiting the degree of exposure of the underlying tables and columns, therefore allowing for better access and permission control. Additionally, views allow simplifying and abstracting often complex queries, which could involve multiple tables. And views also allow for aggregation and quick insight extraction from the data. Let's take a closer look at this feature. First, I'm going to start by going into Compass under the Data Lake menu. And as you can see here, I have a few data objects. Let me walk you through this feature by using a specific business case scenario. What I'm looking at here is a bunch of tables that I have, and these tables contain different pieces of information. But what I need from this scenario specifically is the ability to look at all of the business entity addresses that have not been modified in the past 5 years, and maybe go over and change those in my source system. For me to do that, I have to join two different tables and filter the output. Let's first take a look at each of these tables. We'll start with the business entity address table here, and I'm going to go ahead and pull that up just so you can see what it looks like. As you can see, this is our table. I have the business entity ID, address ID, and some additional metadata here. I need to also look at the address table, which maps the address ID to the various spelled out addresses. By running a similar query, you can see here that we have the address ID, which can be mapped to the other table, and then the address lines, city, province ID, postal code, etc. And at the very end of this table, I have the modified date. Now, for our specific use case today, I'm interested in filtering all the addresses that have not been updated in the past 5 years in order for me to take a closer look at them and potentially update them in the source system. To be able to do that, I need to create an involved query that will combine both tables to give me that information. I've already gone ahead and written this query, which merges the two tables on the address ID column and filters out only the addresses that I need. Let me paste that into the query editor and run it. The output of this query, as you can see, abstracts the underlying logic behind it. There were two tables that we started with, but now ended up with a single table here that only contains the columns that I'm interested in and only the values that I filtered out for my own purpose. Now, if we want to abstract this further, I can simply create a view that includes this query. I can do that by simply adding a create view statement at the beginning. Once I run that query, as you can see here, the view is created. In doing so, I have now created a views object in the data lake. I can view it from the list of the objects here under views. I can query it simply similarly to any other objects in the data lake. And the view is also queryable through the other outlets that Compass provides. This includes the Compass API suites, as well as the JDBC driver, which enables querying through a local SQL client, as you can see here. In addition to being able to simply create views within Compass, these views are automatically indexed and added to the semantic layer provisioned by the data catalog, and are available through a separate menu, as you can see here. This concludes our video today. Thank you for watching. For additional resources related to Infor OS or Data Fabric, please refer to the links in the description. Don't forget to like and subscribe to stay up to date with the latest Infor technology.